What's going on, Dragon Ballers? Welcome back to another discussion video. This time we're going to be talking about what gives certain leaders an edge. So what I mean by that is not all leaders are created equally. Some leaders have certain characteristics or features that kind of give them an edge over other leaders. So I'm kind of going to talk about what I think gives leaders certain edges over other leaders. So we'll start off with the kind of characteristics that some leaders have built right into their effects. So the leader I've pictured right here is the Mecha Frieza leader, arguably at its prime the best leader of all time, because it let you play things for free. It let you cheat energy costs. What it used to be able to do is, instead of paying an energy cost for a extra card, you could take a life to activate that extra card. So if you played like a Planet Vegeta for one energy, instead of playing it for that one energy, you could take a life to hand instead. So you had like self-awakening going on, you had card draw going on, you had manipulating energy going on because you didn't need to use energy to play things. So leaders that let you play things for free are very, very good. We have a couple other leaders that are like this. Now Mecha Frieza is nerfed to where you can only play things on basically on defense for free. So on your opponent's turn, once per turn on the awakened, on the unawakened side, and as many times as you want on your unawakened side, you can activate extra cards by taking a life only during your opponent's turn. So your Bloodlust is still free. Your Nimbuses are still free. Your Negate attacks are still free. So things like that, which makes Mecha Frieza still a very strong leader. But now there are other leaders that also let you do free things, which are really cool. So you have a leader like Dr. Mew lets you play Machine Mutants for free. So that's a way to cheat energy. You have mill leaders like Mira, like Trunks, like Masked Saiyan, like Demigra that let you mill. And what that allows you to do is let you keep playing for free because Overrealm does not cost you much. It usually costs either no energy or one energy, and you play a huge threat for very minimal cost. So your leader just facilitated that, playing that for free. Other things that are built into leaders, we have leaders that self-awaken. In my opinion, the best self-awakening leaders are the ones that take a life to gain critical. So we have like Vegeta and Lord Slug. But then we have some other effects like Caulifla, who takes a life to give the whole field 5k. We have the new Mira leader, who takes a life and mills three. So these leaders are very strong too, because we have card draw, we have self-awaken, we have facilitating our plays. So whether you're trying to deal critical damage or you're trying to mill to set up overrun plays. So leaders that can self-awaken and do something good out of it kind of have an edge over other leaders that can't necessarily self-awaken. Another ability that's built into a leader that makes it relatively strong is the ability to untap energy. So we all know that coming into the set 4 format, Super Saiyan 3 is one of the scariest leaders to play against because it's just so free. So you have, just built into that leader specifically, you do have your self-awaken, but when you do awaken, you get 3 free energy back at the end of every one of your turns. That is so huge because you're essentially able to play with plus 3 energy every turn. So let's say I have 4 energy, I tap 4 to play an 8th blocker, let's just say. And then at the end of my turn, I untap 3. So basically, that turn, I played with 7 energy. And now I have 3 energy to defend myself when it goes back to your turn. And we have other leaders like Soul Striker Goku. We have that new Trunks blue leader that on its awakened side untaps 1 battle card and 1 blue energy at the end of the turn. So being able to untap energy is also very, very strong. Those leaders have done very, very well in the past and will continue to do well in the future. So now we have a couple cards that also give certain leaders a certain boost. So we're going to kind of go over these. So we have the Legendary Flute. So this naturally boosts all blue leaders. This card is absolutely insane. What it allows you to do is just cycle through your deck. So you can play a one drop Boo, draw a card, play the flute, get the Boo back, draw another card. So you have a lot of cycling there. You can attack with a threat that's a 3 drop or lower. So you can attack with like your Intensifying Power Trunks or your Newfound Power Son Gohan. Take the life, attack for a critical. So you got some self-awakening going there. And then instead of letting it sit there and potentially dying that next turn, you just flute it back to your hand so you can use it again next turn if you need to keep self-awakening. It's not just immediately going to die right then and there on the next turn. So flute gave all blue leaders a huge boost. So that kind of is a big thing when you're going to decide to play a blue leader. Then we have these negates like Sacrifice and the other one being Instant Transmission that allow you to negate for free by taking a life if your leader is a certain race. So we have Sacrifice, who allows you to negate without paying your energy cost if your leader's a Namekian. So this thing is really good because you can potentially be tapped out and still have defense. So if your opponent's attacking you, let's say like a triple strike and you're at 3 life, you can negate the attack. Let's say they're trying to put you from 5 to 3 and they're trying to double strike you and you don't want to go to 3. You can sacrifice, negate the attack, take a life, put yourself at a nice smooth 4 life. So that's really, really cool there. That's a big edge for a lot of leaders. So another thing that gives certain leaders a big boost are super combos that are active at 5 life. So we have the Namekians, we have Universe 6, we have a lot of the universes from Tournament of Power actually that have this ability that their super combos are active at 5 or less life. What this helps with is kind of like what I said with Sacrifice. It helps stave off attacks that are trying to put you from like 5 to 3. It just makes your super combos live earlier. So that's really, really helpful, especially in certain situations where your opponent's trying to aggro you really hard. Then we move over to Dauntless Kale. So some of these decks have free blockers. So you have Dauntless Kale, for an example. If your leader is Clefla or you have a Clefla in play, you can play her for free. Just a 5k blocker, but didn't cost you any energy to play. And then you have like Mai with Trunks. You have Videl with Gohan. So those free blockers are really, really strong. Just a free way to protect yourself if you're going to, you know, end up tapping out a lot in your turn, or you're able to search these blockers and you're able to get some kind of use out of them. They're also like cheap threats you can play if you're like ready to end the game with them. Like let's say you can pressure your opponent on their final life with a free blocker that they didn't expect coming, or you can like double strike Chompa it, make it lethal, something like that. Really, really strong. And then we have super combos that have unique effects. So kind of like hand-in-hand with super combos at 5 life, but these are arguably stronger. The example here is Unwavering Solidarity Shugesh. One of the best cards in the game by far. It just allows you to do really broken things. So this super combo for yellow leaders allows you to play 3 drop or lower sands from your hand for free. We have another example being the Stout-Hearted Android 16. If your leader is in a green Android, instead of you drawing a card when you super combo with it, you can make your opponent discard a card. So that's super duper strong. Having these super combos that do really, really, really unique things also will put a leader over the edge, just like Shugesh did with Mecha Frieza back during Mecha Frieza format. And one card that I can't believe I actually forgot to picture on the screen, possibly because I kind of slipped over my head because of the new format coming up and it's not seeing a lot of play, is Cold Bloodlust. Cold Bloodlust leaders have a huge, huge boost. I'm probably downplaying it way too much. Like Cold Bloodlust leaders are some of the only leaders in the game that can negate skills on cards, which is a super strong effect. It's really, really strong. So those types of leaders that can use Cold Bloodlust, Frieza Army leaders particularly, have a very, very big edge over other leaders that can't particularly use those kinds of things. So that's my discussion on leaders that are pushed over the edge by certain characteristics, whether it be a built-in skill that allows them to do something really broken, or a card they have access to that pushes them over the edge. If I miss anything, please let me know. If you guys like this kind of video, let me know. If you disagree with my thoughts, also let me know that. I want to know what you guys think about this discussion. Let's start a discussion in the comments. Let me know what you think. Hope you found this video helpful. Hope you found this video enjoyable. With that being said, my name is Joey from CrossFit TCG, and I'll see you next time.